Good morning. I'm Santosh Bharti. Today I'm going to discuss about the diversity and combining techniques. Basically, what is diversity? Diversity is a scheme which are employed at the receiver side. Basically, if you're talking about the frequency reusing, the frequency reusing techniques which are used to increase the carrier to interference noise. If carrier to interference noise is increased, noise ultimately signal quality is good. And in similar way, diversity is the techniques which are used to minimize the fading of the received signal. For example, suppose here a transmitter and here the receiver. This is the receiver and this is the transmitter. If the receiving side, we have received the more than one signal. Suppose one signal is directly come to the receiver, one signal is suppose by the diffraction, other signal suppose by the ground reflection. These are the signals which are reflected, which are refracted, or which are coming at the receiver side by the different ways. Now, the signal strength of the received signal may be different. Then it is very difficult to receiver side to identify the desired signal. To identify the desired signal or to select the highest signal strength signal, we employ the diversity scheme at the receiving side. See? This diversity scheme are used to minimize the fading of received signal and also help to detect the highest signal strength of the signal or also to identify the desired signal at the receiving side. Right? But before studying the diversity and combining techniques, now I would like to discuss about the bit error rate and word error rate of the fading environment. Basically, bit error rate, before studying the diversity, now I would like to describe the bit error rate and word error rate. In fading radio environment, basically fading means the decrement of the signal strength of the received signal is known as fading. Diversity to minimize the fading of the received signal. And bit error rate, basically how much amount of the error is according to the digital data of the receiving end is known as the bit error rate. Especially bit error rate is described into two environment. One is the first in the Gaussian noise environment. We have to calculate the bit error rate for the Gaussian noise environment. And second part is the relay noise environment. Yeah. In the Gaussian noise environment, basically the bit error rate is the function of signal level. In the Gaussian noise environment, basically the bit error rate is a function of signal level. Means if signal levels are increases, signal level means signal strength at the receiving side is the increases, now bit error rate is the minimum. If signal level is decreases, now bit error rate is maximum. Right? And in the digital communication, suppose let us consider one parameter gamma. Gamma is defined the signal to noise ratio, I mean carrier to noise ratio, or this is equal to signal to noise ratio. And the bit error rate in the digital system of the bit error rate for the different system like differential, phase shift gain, non-coherent frequency shift gain, phase shift gain and coherent frequency shift gain. So in term of digital communication, the bit error rate for DPSK. DPSK stands for differential phase shifting, where the bit error is the function of signal level. Signal level here defined by the new parameter, that is the gamma. Gamma define the carrier to noise ratio or signal to noise ratio. So in terms of this, suppose this is the P is the probability of bit error. This is half of e to the power minus gamma is the probability of bit error for the DPSK signal. Similarly, for the PSK signal, half of the e to the power minus gamma by 2. In previous lecture, basically I derived the formula. This is first probability of error for the DPSK signal, and this second for the probability of error for the non-coherent FSK signal, where P is half of the e to the power minus gamma by 2. Similarly, for the third, the probability error for the PSK signal. Now this is P equals to 1 by 2 ER FC under root gamma. ER FC under root gamma, where ER FC is the complementary error function. Now, before describing the Now, I would like to discuss about what is the relationship between error function and the complementary error function. And for fourth, for the coherent FSK, for the coherent FSK, now probability of bit error is defined by half of the ERFC under root gamma by 2. Under root gamma by 2. So these are the basically probability of bit error, or in simple word, these are the bit error for the digital system. Now these all are basically in the Gaussian noise environment. Before going to detail in the Gaussian noise environment, now I would like to describe basically what is the relationship of the error function and complementary error function. Clear? So basically the error function is defined by, this is the error function ERFX, this is 2 upon under root pi integration of 0 to infinite e to the power minus t square, it is power minus t dt, not t. So this is basically er of x equals to 2 upon under root by integration of 0 to infinite e to the power minus t dt. This is the mathematical relationship of the error function. And erfc x equals to 1 minus ERFX, or this is 1 minus integration 2 upon under root pi integration 0 to x e to the power minus t dt. Clear? E to the power minus t square dt. In simple word, now we can represent this is equals to integration of 2 upon under root pi integration upon x to infinite e t power minus t square dt. This is the formula of complementary error function, and this is the formula of the error function, and this is the relationship between the complementary error function and the error function. On the basis of this relationship, now we describe or we derive the formula for the bit error rate or DPSK, which is P is the half of the e to the power minus gamma, and for non-coherent FSK, P is the half of e to the power minus gamma by 2, and for phase shift keying, P probability of error is the half of E or FC complement error function of under root gamma or under root carrier to noise ratio or under root signal to noise ratio. Similarly for coherent FSK, probability of error is half of the complementary error function of the carrier to noise ratio by 2. Clear? So these all are related to the Gaussian noise environment. Similarly, these all are the basically bit error rate. Similarly, define the void error rate. The void error rate is defined basically in a Gaussian noise environment. The bit error rate depends only upon the signal to noise ratio or carrier to noise ratio. In a void error rate can be obtained by assuming that the error of considering each bit independently is the same as the error of considering each bit with its adjacent bit. Right? Basically, the void error rate is defined by PEW. PEW means probability of error of the void error rate. PEW, it is independent with bit conditions. The void error rate of n bit word after correcting t bit is 1 minus the formula to obtain the word error rate, 1 minus n p of n comma 0 minus summation m equals to 1 to t p n m minus summation m equals to 1 to t 1 to t p of n m, where t is basically the correcting t bits, n is the bit word, but capital N is the bit words, and t is the correcting t bits. Where PNM is the probability that given word length of the n bit and m bit in error. So basically this p of n comma m represents the probability that given word length of the n bit and m bit error, this is the bit word and m represents the number of errors, right? So this formula is very helpful to find or to determine the word error rate. Similarly, now this p of n m is represented by the factorial n upon factorial m into factorial n minus m into 1 minus probability of error power n minus m into p e of power m. Clear? Now this formula basically defined by the where n is the number of bits and is the number of errors. Or we can write this is also factorial n upon same formula can be used to determine the word error rate. So this is basically the bit error rate and word error rate in the Gaussian noise environment. Similarly, we can find the bit error rate and word error rate in the Rayleigh noise environment. In Rayleigh noise environment, in the relay noise environment, basically, however, the received carrier to noise varies due to the multipath failing. Basically, this carrier to noise ratio is varies with the multipath failing. Carrier to noise ratio varies with multipath failing means the next formula. But the probability of bit error in using is the Gaussian noise environment cannot be used same formula for the relay noise environment because here the carrier to noise ratio or signal to noise ratio is depend upon the multipath fading. Means varies according to multipath fading, varies according to received signal strength at the receiver due to the relay fading environment or relay noise environment. Right? So here now define the average probability of bit error in the relay fading environment. Of probability of bit error is defined by this PV. This is equal to integration of 0 to infinite P into P gamma into T of gamma. But this P gamma represents the probability density function, probability distribution function of the random variable. And this P is basically the probability of bit error in term of the Gaussian noise environment. Right? So far similarly, to calculate the probability of bit error, average P for now average P for in this formula basically this P represents the average probability of bit error and P gamma is the PD of probability distribution function of the random variable or the relay variable. Every nanometer means signal is defined by the random variable. This is the probability density function of the relay noise and gamma is the and basically. Now this is equals to basically this P of gamma. This P of gamma equals to basically 1 by capital gamma exponential of minus gamma upon capital gamma where this gamma is greater than or equals to 0. Where this capital gamma is average carrier to noise ratio or average signal to noise ratio and small gamma is the carrier to noise ratio or signal to noise ratio. So this formula is basically used to determine the probability of bit error in relay fading environment or relay noise environment. So this is the general formula to calculate the probability of bit error in the relay environment. So for example, if we want to calculate the probability of bit error in the differential PSK, DPSK means average probability of error for differential phase shifting in the relay noise environment. In the relay noise environment. Now this is the general formula. Now we know that in the Gaussian noise environment, now this PE for the DPSK is how much? 1 by 2 e to the power minus gamma. Now substitute this value here in this equation. So this is integration from 0 to infinite, p is 1 by 2 e to the power minus gamma into, now the probability distribution function of the Rayleigh noise is 1 upon capital gamma e to the power minus gamma upon capital gamma and d of gamma. Now we can put this is 1 by 2 and 1 by capital gamma. Take out the common. Integration of 0 to infinite e to the power minus gamma minus gamma upon capital gamma d gamma. This is equals to 1 upon 2 gamma 0 to infinite e to the power minus gamma, take common, 1 minus 1 by minus gamma common, 1 plus 1 by gamma d gamma, right? When you find the integration, it is 1 by 2 gamma into, now integration of e to the power x is e to the power x upon d x into e to the power minus x. So this is e to the power minus gamma 1 plus 1 by gamma upon d gamma e to the power minus gamma 1 plus 0 to infinite. It will come 1 by 2 of capital gamma into minus half gamma plus 1 upon gamma into e to the power minus infinite minus e to the power 0. So e to the power 0, e to the power 0 is 1. 1 means this is minus 1, this minus, multiply by minus, by minus is plus, and it will come like 1 by 2 gamma into gamma upon gamma plus 1. Gamma is cancelled by gamma. Now this is 1 upon 2 gamma plus 1. This is the average probability of Betterer for the DPSK signal. This is the probability of Betterer for the DPSK signal, that is PE cap is to 1 by 2 in similar fashion we can calculate the probability, average probability of Betterer for non-coherent FSK. For non-coherent FSK, now the probability of Betterer in the Gaussian noise environment, this is equal to gamma by 2. This is equal to gamma by 2. Now apply here, this is gamma by 2. We will find basically this is, gamma by 2 applying. Now the probability of Betterer in non-coherent FSK, in this formula we will get this is equals to 1 upon 2 gamma is common 0 to infinite e to the power minus gamma is common 1 by 2 plus 1 by gamma d gamma. We will find 1 by 2 of capital gamma into minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by gamma e to the power minus infinite e to the power minus 0. The minus minus plus, this is 1 by 2 gamma into gamma plus 2 upon 2 gamma. 2 gamma is cancelled by 2 gamma. Now it will come, that is the gamma plus 2. 1 upon gamma plus 2. So this is the probability of error. This is the probability of error for the FSK signal. Non-coherent FSK. Similarly, by using same fashion or by doing same fixed fashion, we can calculate the average probability of bit error for the PSK signal and for the coherent FSK signal in the relay noise environment. Similarly, this is for the non-coherent FSK. Similarly, for the PSK signal, now average probability of bit error rate is comes half of the one minus under root capital gamma upon capital gamma plus 1. So this is the average probability of bit error for the phase shifting in the relay noise environment. Similarly, for coherent FSK or synchronous FSK, what do you mean by coherent or synchronous? Synchronous FSK means this is the using the synchronous receiver or coherent receiver, means the carrier frequency of the receiver is exactly same as the carrier frequency used at the transmitter side. If this situation is happened, now that system is known as coherent system, that receiver is known as coherent receiver. Here, so for this case, basically the average probability of bit error in the relay noise environment, this is half of one minus under root gamma upon gamma plus 2. So these are the important formulas which are used to determine the values of probability of bit error in the different noise environment. So these are the formulas. Before that, I describe the formula to calculate the probability of bit error in the Gaussian noise environment, and these are the formulas which describe the average probability of bit error. Why calculate the average? Because here the probability of bit error is not only depend upon the signal level, but it is depend upon the multipath fading. That's why the same formula cannot be used here. So these are related with the bit error rate and word error rate for the different noise environment. Now I'm going to describe the diversity scheme. In the diversity scheme, basically diversity are used to minimize the fading signal. Fading signal means it may be the single fading signal or multipath fading signal. So there are some techniques which are used to describing the fading of the received signal. I listed here so many definitions of the diversity. Diversity scheme provides two or more input at the receiver such that the fading phenomena among these inputs are uncorrelated. Or if one radio path undergoes deep fade means highly affected by the diffraction, reflection and refraction. If one radio path undergoes deep fade at a particular point in time, another independent means or at least high uncorrelated path may have a strong signal at that point. If the probability of deep fade in one channel is P, then probability of n channel is basically P into N. A diversity scheme is a method that is used to develop information from several signal transmitted over independent fading path. It exploit the random nature of the radio propagation by finding independent signal path for communication. So these are the different way to define the diversity. Basically, diversity techniques are characterized into two parts. One is the macroscopic diversity and other is the microscopic diversity. Microscopic diversity is basically used for the long time of events, means signal varying with the large time scale. While microscopic diversity, basically the signal variations in very small time span. Clear? So these are the two types, basically microscopic diversity and microscopic diversity. Now I am going to differentiate these two types of diversities. In macroscopic diversity is basically prevent large scale fading or reduces large scale fading. While microscopic diversity basically reduces the small scale fading or minimizes the small scale fading. Basically macroscopic diversity is applied on separated antenna side. While microscopic diversity is applied on co-located antenna side. Now other differentiation of this microscopic and microscopic is large scale fading is caused by shadowing due to variation in both the terrain profile and the nature of the surroundings, while small scale fading is caused by multiple reflection from the surroundings. Multiple reflection means maybe signal is reflected from the some shining haze, some shining building, some shining towers. These multiple types of signal is received at the receiving signal is known as small scale fading. Clear? And third type, the large scale fading is large normally distributed signal. In simple word, we can say large scale fading is basically described by the large normal distribution. While the small scale fading is characterized by deep and rapid amplitude fluctuation which occur at the mobile moves over the distance of the few wavelengths. Moves over the distance of the few wavelengths. Right? And the last point of the differentiation of this diversity technique is the now this large scale fading is prevented by selecting an antenna which is not shadowed when others are. Basically the large scale fading is prevented by selecting an antenna which is not shadowed when others are shadowed. This allows increase in the signal to noise ratio. And in other word, basically at the other end, the short-term fading is prevented by the selecting an antenna which gives a strong signal, that mitigates this is a small signal fading effect. Now you can see here this point, this fading is prevented by the selecting an antenna which gives a strong signal that mitigates this small signal fading effect. Now basically the types of the fadings. So this is the general block diagram of fading. Now this is the transmitter circuit, this is the transmitting antenna. Now signal is transmitted by the transmitting antenna. This will be the electromagnetic wave. This is the electromagnetic wave. Similarly, it may be the more than one. But I am considering only one signal. Suppose one signal is received by some diffraction, suppose receiver this, some is by some reflection, some is by ground reflection. So there are m receivers are used to receive the different signal strength of the signal. Suppose receiver 1, 2 and up to m. So these are the general block diagram of the diversity techniques. Now I am going to discuss about the types of diversities. So there are four types of diversities. Now the first type is the polarization diversity, then space diversity, frequency diversity and the time diversity. Basically this space diversity is also characterized into four types. It's a selection diversities, scanning diversities, maximal ratio diversities and equal gain diversity. Now these techniques are basically known as combining techniques. These techniques are known as combining techniques. Now I'm going to discuss in detail of the different types of diversities. The first type is basically space diversity. In principle, space diversity is a method of transmission or reception or both. Basically, this is the transmitting or receiving or trans receiving means transmitting as well as receiving, in which the effect of fading are minimized by the simultaneous use of two or more physically separated antennas. Basically, you can see this is the transmitting antenna, this is the one antenna, but at the receiver side it uses the two or more than two antennas. This is the normal signal means direct line of signal, this is the faded signal. Faded signal means maybe signal is reflected by some object, maybe signal diffracted by some object, or basically this is the reflected signal. Clear? Means this is the direct wave, this is the non-direct wave. Signal received from spatially separated antenna on the mobile would have essentially uncorrelated envelope for the antenna separation of one half wavelength or more. So by this way now we can identify the desired signal through the space diversity. Why it is called space diversity? Because at the mobile unit now some space is provided between the antenna located at the receiving units. So this is the block diagram of the space diversity. These are the basically repeat the antenna 1, antenna 2, antenna 3. Now you can use more than one antenna, and this is the switching logic or demodulator. Switching logic, which is basically identify the desired signal and demodulate at the receiving signals. Basically, this space diversity is divided into four types: selection, scanning, maximal ratio, and equal gain. Now these are also known as the combining techniques. Now later I will discuss about the combining techniques. After now describing the different types of diversity techniques. Now another techniques are the polarization diversity. In the polarization diversity relies on the decorrelation of the two receive port to achieve diversity gain. High diversity gain is possible if the received signal has a good signal strength, right? The two receiver port must remain cross polarized. The effective diversity is obtained with a correlation coefficient below 0.7. In order to keep the correlation at this level, the space diversity at the base station requires antenna spacing up to 20 wavelength for the broadside case and even more for the inline case. At the base station, space diversity is considerably less practical than at the mobile, because the narrow angle of incident field required for large antenna spacing and the comparatively high cost of using space diversity at the base station. If we compare the space diversity with the polarization diversity, now the cost of space diversity is much higher than the polarization diversity because it uses the more than one antenna at the mobile unit at the receiving side, right? Basically, the cost using space diversity at the large base station prompt to consideration of the using orthogonal polarization. The polarization diversity provide two diversity branches and allow the antenna element to be considered. Now you can see in the graphical form, in the diagram form, basically this is the cross polarization. In the polarization diversity at the receiving side, now poles are used in the cross section, but in the space diversity it uses the more than one antenna, right? In the early days of the cellular radios, all subscriber units were mounted in the vehicles or used vertical with antennas. Today, however, over half of the subscriber units are portable. This means that most subscribers are no longer using vertical polarization due to hand tilting when the portable cellular phone is used. This recent phenomena has sparked interest in the polarization diversity as the base station. Right? In conclusion of the polarization diversity, basically the multiple version of the signal are transmitted and received by antenna with the different polarization. A diversity combining techniques are applied on the receiver side to identify the desired signal at the destination point. These all are related to the polarization diversity. And next type of the diversity is the frequency diversity. In the frequency diversity, the signal is transmitted using several frequency channels are spread over wide spectrum that is affected by the frequency selective fading. Frequency selective fading means among the different frequencies of the received signal to select the desired frequency is known as frequency selective fading. Right? Now here again only one antenna is used at the receiver side and one antenna is used at the transmitter side. By using some logical element means active transmitter frequency 1 plus now product of the transmitter frequency 2 and same way it receives the frequency 1 and 2 at the receiving antenna. So depending upon the amount of magnitude of the frequency, it identifies the desired signal. The principle of diversity, frequency diversity, basically the same information signal is transmitted and received simultaneously on two or more independent fading carrier frequencies. The rationale behind this technique is that frequency is separated by more than the coherence bandwidth of the channel will not experience the same fade. The probability of simultaneous fade will be the product of individual fading probabilities. This is often employed in microwave line of sight link which carries several channels in the frequency division multiplexing mode, that is the FDM mode. FDM mode means wide frequency, wide spectrum is divided into the smaller frequency range is known as the FDM. This is technique not only requires spare bandwidth but also requires that there be a many receivers as there are channels used for the frequency diversity. However, for critical traffic, the expansion may be justified. Now I am going to discuss the last type of the diversity, that is the time diversity. In the time diversity, the signal representing the same information are sent over the same channel at different time. I mean the signal representing the same information. Same information are sent over the channel, over the same channel at the different time. Now multiple version of the same signal are transmitted at the different time instances. The time diversity repeatedly transmit information at the time spacing that exceeds the coherence time of the channel. Now multiple repetition of the signal will be received with the multiple fading conditions, thereby providing for diversities. A modern implementation of time diversity involves the use of rake receiver. Basically, rake receiver is the arrangement of the receiving multiple copies of the fade signal and it gives the desired signal at the destination point. Similarly, alternatively, a redundant forward error correction code is added and the message is spread in time by means of bit interleaving before it is transmitted. What do you mean redundant? Redundant information means this is the unwanted information or undesired information is known as redundant information. And now error bursts are avoided which simplifies the error correction. Basically in digital communication there are two theorems are used for the error detection as well as error correction. So these all are related to with the error correction and error detection capability. So these all are basically related to the types of diversity. One more types of diversity is known as field components of diversity. These are the mathematical derivation and this is the graphical, and you can see suppose this is the EZ is the field strength in the direction of Z, where HX is the magnetic field strength in the X direction, Y direction. Here when we calculate the total field magnitude in the direction of Z, now this is the combination of all the direction, this gives the field diversity schemes. Now I am going to discuss the diversity combining techniques. So there are four types of diversity combining techniques. First is selection combining techniques. Now there is the switching or scanning combining techniques. In scanning combining techniques, basically at the receiving side the antenna is scanning the signal strength fading strength. If the received signal strength is less than the threshold value, it again re-scanning of the antenna. But if the received signal strength is greater than or equal to threshold value, now scanning is stopped and it identifies the desired signal. And next, the equal gain combining techniques. This is again, these are the techniques, combining techniques to minimize the fading of the received signal or multiple copy of the received signal. And next one is the maximum ratio combining techniques. Now I'm going to discuss now these combining techniques in the detail. Basically, this is the block diagram of the selection combining techniques. This is the transmitter. Now signal is transmitted in the this the one antenna, two antenna, and maybe the antenna. This is the select the best antenna. Select the best antenna means the signal strength, which antenna has the best signal strength. That is the select by the this magic block. So in the selection diversity, selecting the best signal among all signals received from the different branches at the receiving end. Now derivation of selection diversity improvement, basically it has the some derivation techniques. Derivation of selection techniques improve the signal to noise ratio or carrier to noise ratio at the receiving end. Basically, now already I told these are the derivation related to, now this part already I completed in the classroom. Now feedback or scanning diversity, basically it scans the antenna if the received signal strength is below the threshold value. If it is above the threshold value, now we stop the scanning. Next is the maximal ratio combining techniques. In combining all the signal in co-phased and weighted manner so as to have the highest achievable signal to noise ratio or highest achievable carrier to noise ratio at the receiver at all time. Consider M branches which are maximal ratio combined in a co-phased and weighted manner in order to achieve the high signal to noise ratio. Let's see, this is the part for time being. I skip now this part, the derivation part, and the equal gain combining techniques. Combining all the signal in co-phase manner with unity weight for the signal level so as to have the highest achievable signal to noise ratio or highest achievable carrier to noise ratio at the receiver at all the time. Basically, that's why it is called unity gain combining techniques, because it uses the weight of unity or unity weight of the signals. That's all. Thank you. Next lecture, I will discuss some other new topics.